Hey there. So it is Sunday, and usually on the weekend, I'll go and visit my family and spend some time with them because weekends in Arkansas can be pretty boring. Like sometimes we'll spend our entire day trying to think of something to do, and we'll end up going to Branson, Missouri. And you live in a pretty boring state if you have to go to a different state to do something fun. But today, I didn't think it would be a very good idea to go visit my family because I'm sick. Hence the ramen. So now is a good time to do something that I've been wanting to do for a while. So a while back, I discovered the concept of liminal space, and it's very intriguing. Now, some of you watching may not be familiar with this concept. I'll try to explain it the best I can. But basically, liminal space is a type of art where you take pictures of transitional places, such as a hallway or a mall or an airport, places between one thing and another thing, one place and another place, or one state of being and another state of being. And most of the time, these liminal space photos will be taken with a very lo-fi quality camera, or during an abandoned state, or a closed state. And most of the time, these photos are of places that should have a lot of people in them, but don't. Like, there's no people here, there's bad lighting, there's an unsettling, creepy, or even calm vibe to them. Now that's a key thing to note. Most of these either give off a very peaceful vibe or a very eerie vibe. And that's what I'm gonna be doing today. I'm gonna be going onto the Liminal Space subreddit because yes, there is a whole cult following of this. And I'm going to be rating Liminal Space photos either creepy or calming. Most of the time, I'll find them calming because to me, liminal spaces are nostalgic and very tranquil. A lot of them will be very eerie, uncanny, and just flat out creepy.
Oh, that's so good.
So without further ado, let me kill the motor and dive in. Let's begin this. So the description on the subreddit says, a liminal space is the time between the what was and the next. It is a place of transition, waiting, and not knowing. Liminal space is where all transformation takes place if we learn to wait and let it form us. Which is not a super helpful description. Like, are you confused? I don't blame you. Basically, a liminal space is a photo of a place that is completely empty. Like, a key element to these photos is that there's no life around. There's no people, there's no animals. And I prefer there to be no cars, but some of them do have cars. Okay, so here's our first liminal space photo. The caption reads, took photo today at 4 a.m. Was it a dream? I don't know. That's a really good one. Like, the mist or fog, whatever it is, there's a power line, which is cool.
Thanks, Captain Obvious.
I love the grainy quality. Like, there's these lines. I don't know if that's a fence going across the bottom of the frame or just like some kind of artifact, but it's really cool. It looks very lo-fi. I like the filter, if there is a filter used on this. I like how you can't see the horizon or any depth. It's all just muted out by the sheer abyss of the fog. This is somewhere between creepy and calming. It's creepy because there's a sense of unknowing. There's like no closure. There's just like, you don't know what's beyond this. It's kind of unsettling in that aspect, but it's also very peaceful and calming because I've spent a lot of time out in fields while it was foggy, and it's kind of a good memory. So I would rate this calming. Our next photo is of what appears to be a slide, and I don't even know what that red thing is, on top of a rolling green hill. And I love these photos because there's something about them. They're kind of like those old Windows backgrounds. My childhood park feels off now that I think about it. Why though? I think it's because, I don't know, this is a park. There's only a slide and whatever this red thing is. Is that a dumpster? Yeah, I don't know what that red thing is, but it's just a slide on top of a hill. And the fact that we can't see beyond this hill is kind of, it kind of makes me feel uneasy. I'd say this is pretty calming. Like, I would love to just be a kid going down the slide over and over again on top of this hill with this gray sky. I mean, the gray sky completes it. The gray sky is the cherry on top. I love gray sky. Like, that's That's what I consider to be perfect weather. Just gray sky, a breeze, you can smell the storm coming. That's just perfect. That's calming. That is 100% calming. Randomly found when scrolling eBay auctions today. Yeah, eBay photos and Craigslist and stuff really do be giving off those liminal space vibes. Had to share, welcome to a different game of pool. Yeah, that's a little weird. The lack of, like, everything in this room is a little odd. I mean, like, there's a billiards table here, right amidst these thin beams, and then there's a staircase in the middle, but besides that, there's like nothing going on in this room. I like the teal walls. It kind of like completes the weird look of this place. Like, what, why is the floor tiled? I imagine this is in some kind of basement, but the ceiling kind of suggests as in, I don't know, a school or something. It says eBay auctions. What does that mean? Are they auctioning the billiards table or the house? Since it reminds me of like the basement of a church, VBS, having potlucks and dish to passes, or dishes to pass, whatever the plural of that is, in the basement of churches as a kid, I'm gonna rate this calming. And I feel like I'm gonna rate most of these calming because that's what liminal spaces are to me. Like, for a lot of people, they're creepy and uncanny and just unsettling. But for me, a lot of liminal spaces are just peaceful and they remind me of my childhood. Oh, I like this one. Oh, this is good. This is a good one. Berlin subway station. Yeah, that's nice. I like that shade of, like, pink. That's a very nice peach color. And then, I don't know why the doors appear to be, like, blue. But this is really nice. I like this. Central Library, National University of Singapore. That is interesting. What is going on with the architecture here? Okay, first off, who decided to make the walls yellow? Like, the foreman was like, hey, what's like the nicest color we can paint these walls? Let's paint it the opposite of that. Like, I don't even know what's going on with any of this. It's weird. Like, the gray stairs too. Like, this looks like a Lego house. I don't know what to rate this. Kind of reminds me of a museum. I'm gonna say calming. Also, I forgot to rate this one. I'll definitely say this is calming. After the party. Now this one, I would say creepy, because I don't know, just the carpet, the fact that it's somebody's house that I don't know. Like, I don't know this person. It's very unfamiliar. But at the same time, it is kind of familiar. I mean, these are strangely familiar places. That's what people describe liminal spaces as, strangely familiar places. Now, this is familiar as in, of course, I've been in a room before with a carpet and sofas and stuff. I've been at the birthday party of, like, a friend or whatever, a cousin. But it's also unfamiliar because I don't know whose house this is. And I feel like I'm not supposed to be here. Like, this is after the party. I mean, as the description explicitly says. But, like, look at the decorations. They're all over the floor. What were they doing at this party? This is creepy. The hotel I'm staying tonight. I think they meant staying at tonight. But Reddit is not really a reliable source to find good grammar.
Shots fired!
The hotel I'm staying at tonight. That looks like a cruise ship. Like, I've never been to a I've never been to a hotel this big, a resort like this, but I've never been to a hotel that has a courtroom like this. And it appears there is, like, a glass ceiling, like, a sort of greenhouse type of skylight thing going on up here, like a giant aviary sort of dome roof, like in Jurassic World. But yeah, this looks like a cruise ship to me. It also looks like a multi-layer mall, like with a million mezzanines. But that's pretty cool. The fact that there's like nobody around, I'm gonna say it's creepy. Made this 3D render a little over half a year ago. Does this look liminal in any way? I'm gonna tell you right now that a lot of these posts will be like asking, is this liminal? Not sure if this is liminal, but do you guys think this is liminal? Does this fit the description of liminal? Stop doing that. It's so annoying. I don't know. It's just my pet peeve. Like, stop asking if it's liminal. If it's a photo that gives you a calming or unsettling vibe, yes, it doesn't matter. It doesn't have to be specifically a transitional space. Sorry. not to rant or anything, but stop asking if it's a liminal photo. If it's a photo with some type of vibe going on, you've got yourself a liminal space photo. Post it. Yeah, this is definitely, I'm not really a big fan of the 3D render ones, like the fake CGI ones, but I kind of like the pool rooms. in the back rooms. Like, of course, the back rooms is where the liminal space concept kind of took off. But this is calming. This is definitely calming. I like how you can see, like, the sky, suggesting that it's on, like, a higher... Either a high story of a building, or it's just, like, on the coast, and you can... You're just, like, on a cliffside, and I imagine you could look out to the ocean. But I like that the sky is there. It gives it a very open... Just a nice feeling, like you can breathe, much like I can't right now with my stuffy nose. But these, if I was the architect, or rather the person who made this 3D render, I would make these slides like just white or something. But it's kind of cool that they're color coded. I imagine that this staircase goes up to the top of the slides. But I've seen a picture exactly like this, and I'm gonna point out something. That you're not going to want to go down that red slide, trust me. There's a railing right there you're going to fly right into. Not to mention, there's probably stairs under there. And, yeah, it's probably pretty shallow, I would imagine. I also wouldn't recommend going down the blue slide, because you would probably land on some sort of shallow end. Green slide is a little too close to that window there. Go down the yellow slide, bottom line. But this is nice. This is definitely calming. Okay, now this is a back rooms photo. What is the most liminal object for you? Object. Now that's an interesting proposition. The object that looks best in a liminal space. I go first. Chair. I agree. Yeah, definitely a chair. That's an interesting proposition. What is the most liminal object for you? Like, we always think of liminal spaces, but what's the most liminal object? The object that looks the best in a liminal space. And I think they got it right. Like, a chair. Yeah, a chair. Definitely a chair. Man, this is still hot, and I made it an hour ago. Now, this is creepy. The backrooms photos are always pretty creepy. I want to look at the comments. See what other people came up with. Wall. Yeah, that's a little essential. Signs. That's a good one. Stop signs. I like when they have stop signs. Now I have one. Sofa. I like when they have sofas, because sofas are always like very musty and they smell weird, and they're dusty, and they give off a sort of unsettling vibe. Where did you go? I don't know. I just stepped out of my house one night and I ended up here. That's like a suburban street at night. There's like this amber colored light here. It's just straight up yellow. Fire hydrant I can see over here.
Thanks, Captain Obvious.
That's calming. I like walking around like these neighborhoods at night. Like, that's my childhood. Walking around the suburban neighborhood at night while it was like the 4th of July or something, the night before maybe, with the people setting off fireworks. That's just a nice feeling. So this is calming. Unattended second concessions. I gotta blow my nose.
Clarity.
Yeah, the ramen doesn't really help with the nose thing, because my nose runs when I eat hot food. Unattended second concession stand in the back of a movie theater. Movie theaters really do be giving off that vibe. That, I'd say, is calming, just because movie theaters in general are pretty good memories. Unless you're one of those people who submitted one of those creepy movie theater stories to Mr. Nightmare. Grandma's house in a museum? Wait, what? Grandma's house in a museum. This is creepy. This is creepy. Like, why is there a display in a museum of somebody's grandma's house? Like, this isn't my grandma's house. Is it the poster's grandma's house? I don't know. Your guess is as good as mine. I'm like, what? What are we looking at here? Why is there a display of grandma's house? Is this, like, somebody, like, notable? I don't know. It's creepy. I always find it unsettling when there's, like... I mean, I'm gonna describe, like, literally every museum out there, but I find it unsettling when there's, like, objects... in a museum. And what I mean by that is, like, things like chairs and tables and, like, household objects, furniture, appliances, it's kind of creepy because, you know, somebody at some point in time owned this, and they're probably dead now. When I was a kid, we used to visit the New York State Museum, and there was this fire truck from 9/11 that was just all charred and burned up and crushed, and it was really creepy. Welcome home. That's not my home. Is that your home? That is weird. What is this place? Like, it looks like there's a stadium or something. Or just, like, there's lights up there on the ceiling, in the rafters. What is this? What is going on here? But more importantly, what is going on here? Like, what is this rainbow cave? It's definitely not dark enough to be creepy, but it's not calming either. It's just weird. It's just flat out weird. I don't think we're home anymore. That caption, that sets the scene. Now, this is cool because there's actually a place fairly nearby that looks like this slightly. Just the way that the staircase wraps around this rock wall. There's not a tunnel there, but it reminds me of that place. And like the fog, just like you can't see your imminent death if you slip under the railing. Like, what is going on with the railing here? Like, what? Why are there no rungs? Like a big rock or something in the way, but like if you're, I mean, there's nothing to stop you from falling through there. I mean, a lot of people would say this is creepy, but I'm gonna say it's calming. Real old picture my sister took. Yeah, this is a good one. This is a really good one because, I mean, I always find these colorful, like, playground ones, like indoor playground ones, kind of creepy. There's like a playground like this at the Battlefield Mall in Springfield, and it's kind of weird, especially because there's like kids playing inside of it, but it's gated off, like it's closed. The entrance has a gate over it. It's kind of creepy. This reminds me of those old McDonald's indoor playgrounds. Like, oh man, you remember those things? Like, there's a McDonald's in town that I used to go to for a while, and I never noticed that it had an indoor playground. Like, I never even realized it was there. This is kind of calming, because as a kid, I loved these sorts of places. If you need me, I'll be chilling at the eye exam house. Yeah, so this is not an eye exam house. This is the photo that they show you in those, like, things at when you take an eye exam. That's funny, I love this. I wonder where they got this photo. Like, I feel like it's exclusive to, like, eye doctors, but they got their hands on this photo, and yeah, this is definitely liminal. Look at this. I love this, like, how it's, like, a field, almost like a farm, and there's just, like, this white fence. Like, I would imagine there would be, like, cattle or, like, animals or something in these, within these pastures, and there's just, like, this row of grass in between these two fences for you to be able to get to the house. Or barn, whatever this is. Maybe it's a stable. I don't know. But yeah, this is nice. This is calming and nostalgic for any of you who have taken an eye exam. But yeah, that's gonna wrap it up for today. Leave a like if you enjoyed this video. Leave a comment if you have anything to say. You can subscribe if you want to. You don't have to, but I mean, like, nobody's gonna force you to. I'm a nice guy. I would never, like, force you. With that being said, I sincerely hope you have a good day. You will see me in the next one. God bless, and peace out.